And the Bay Area got a bit of a wake-up call today when the Centers for Disease Control released a new map that shows the Bay Area is now in the danger zone for the Zika virus. KPIX 5 reporter Emily Turner says this is not what pregnant women want to hear. Emily?
Not at all. Not at all, Veronica. That is not what they wanted to hear. They thought, you know what? It's in other places of the country. It's in Central America. It's in South America. It's not here. We don't really have to worry about it as long as we don't go or our partners don't go. Now, that's not the case. Expectant mother Adina Blair is ready for baby number two, not only because she's excited to meet her, but also because she's ready to be done with the threat of the Zika virus.
It's kind of frightening. I kind of thought it was never something I needed to worry about. So yeah, a little terrifying.
Originally, the virus-carrying mosquitoes were supposed to be contained in the southern Gulf states and parts of the southwest in Southern California. But today, the Centers for Disease Control and Prevention updated their maps. Based on new scientific information, possible areas now include the Midwest, New England, and reach farther into Northern California, encompassing the Bay Area.
The temperatures are becoming warmer. The humidity is a little higher in our area. These mosquitoes are invasive, meaning they California is not their normal home. So once they are introduced into our area, they will take hold, and they're difficult, very difficult to eradicate.
So far, the species of mosquito that carries the Zika virus hasn't arrived in the Bay Area. But according to the CDC's map, that doesn't mean it won't. And that has women like Adina on edge.
The past 3 years, we've actually been doing surveillance for Aedes albopictus and aegypti. And we're going to continue to do surveillance for these mosquitoes in the coming year.
Marin Sonoma Mosquito and Vector Control is on alert as well. There's not much they can do until the species shows up, but they're keeping a wary eye out for when and if they do.
Luckily, I'm due soon, so I feel like I'm probably a little safe, but if I were earlier on, I would, you know, and I'll definitely tell my girlfriends.
And Mosquito and Vector Control says there are some things that you can do at home to make sure that you keep these invasive species from getting here. One of them is to keep an eye on standing water. Obviously, you can't do something about something like this that's already there, but these mosquitoes can live in anything or start their lifespan in anything as small as like a bottle cap full of water. So if you have anything in your backyard, a baby pool, or even, you know, a candle that overflowed, anything like that in these rains, they say tip it out, make sure that water is not standing. Reporting live in Marin, Emily Turner, KPIX 5.